Barefooted with others in slippers, they trekked to the riverside. Residents wade through cow dung, dragging it into their own source of drinking water. This is the daily life of most rural folks in the Volta region. The pregnant and nursing mothers alike at Yekutikpo rely on this water for cooking. To really prove that this is the kind of water people here drink, we journeyed to Tova, a nearby village, and we met a group already coming from the riverside, confirming many people fetched water from here. Looking at the color of the water, I thought it was used for watering their farms, but I was shocked to know that this is the water they drink, sharing it with cattle, goat, and other animals. This water is what they have been drinking all their lives. Mama V. Nukunya said, the color of the water even discolors her banku.
We cook with it. The water is not good. When we cook banku with it, it becomes dark. Cows drink with us and they also urinate in the water.
It is more worrying when children drink the water. Mama V has a 1.5-year-old son who experiences diarrhea anytime he takes this discolored water. On days she can afford to take him to the hospital, that is when she gives him sachet water.
My son gets diarrhea often. He urinates often. The doctor says the water is bad. I can only afford sachet water upon the doctor's prescription.
Just in the middle of the interview, this man began to drink the water, proving that was the water they drank. An oily substance on the face of the water, the village folks told us, is also worrying. For Efo Gakpo, a promise by their MP to provide potable water has kept too long.
The last time, they provided a borehole, but the water was too salty. Our MP, Honorable Joe Gidisu, promised us pipe-borne water, but that is yet to come.
TV3's Ghana's Most Beautiful went scouting for this location, and she indicated with pregnant women and children at the center of her project, she hopes to raise money to help dig a borehole.
If I'm thinking of good water and women and I should find this, I actually would love to bring pipe-borne water, but I'm just a personality. I'm just Ghana's Most Beautiful. I will talk to the government. But if they can't, what do I do? Would I have to raise funds to start with a borehole? They're actually complaining that the borehole contains salt water and all that, but I still would bargain that to this drinking water because we can't feed this to the children and then to women, especially those who are pregnant.
Till her project is completed, people at Tova will only be sharing water with cattle and have the color of their banku darkened by the bad water. Odilio Fori, TV3 News.